Purdue Office of Technology Commercialization works to move Purdue's discoveries to the public. The office filed more than 300 global patents last year, patents for discoveries like a technology that can emulate human vision. Enabling robots and other machines to see the world in 3D like humans is one of the biggest challenges in robotic and mechanical development. Purdue University professor Zygmunt Pieslow has been studying human visual perception for 30 years. Pieslow and his research team have created a dance floor in his visual perception laboratory where robots like Chopik can further develop artificial intelligence and use its visual system to see objects in 3D.
What is even more important is that trying to build a robot which can see exactly the same as we do will make sure that the robot and human will understand each other. So when we think about the future applications, if we think that the robot and humans are supposed to interact, they should be able to predict what the other will be able to see.
They discovered that human vision relies on a prior knowledge about the physical environment.
The key breakthrough in solving the problem is to realize that the human visual system is bringing a priori knowledge about the physical world. The physical world is not completely random. One of the main regularities in the physical world is symmetry of objects. All objects have volume. The gravity is always present. The ground surface is approximately horizontal. So there is enough of the a priori knowledge that the human visual system can use, and combining it with two-dimensional image does the trick.
By programming in this prior knowledge, Pieslow and his team are helping mechanical robots and other machines translate a 2D image into a 3D object by mimicking human visual performance.
Well, emulating human vision will be a key factor of bringing robots to our everyday life. They are used on manufacturing lines. We send them to Mars, but they don't bring us a coffee in the morning. Once the robot is able to see as well as humans, then there is a reason to trust them and to consider them safe.
With robots able to see like us, this vision could enable a golden age of robot mechanics by helping doctors perform surgery, assist people with disabilities, provide services for the elderly, or replace humans in high-risk situations, such as fighting fires.
If you want to do repair in a nuclear plant, it's definitely better to send a robot. Driving cars, assisting old and elderly and sick or disabled, would be another way or place where the robot could actually be of great help. The blind people so far, they would use a stick to walk around. One can easily envision having two cameras on person's chest. It could be two cameras in an iPhone, and then the iPhone could be talking to you and telling you which way to go.
The technology on robotic vision is available for licensing through the Purdue Office of Technology Commercialization. For more information, visit otc-prf.org.